Do you know that 44% of first-time home buyers regret not asking their mortgage advisor enough questions before signing the dotted line? Let's make sure you're not one of them. Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you the essential questions that you need to be asking your mortgage advisor to ensure you're making informed decision about buying your first home. Let's dive in. Question one, are you regulated? It is crucial to ensure that the mortgage advisor you are working with is regulated by the Financial Conduct Authority, FCA. This regulation means that they are legally required to give advice that is in your best interest, ensuring transparency and protection throughout the mortgage process. Now, without FCA regulation, you risk working with an unregulated broker who may not be held to the same standard of professionalism or consumer protection. You can easily check if your broker is regulated by searching the FCA register online. This register allows you to verify that they are authorized to give financial advice and handle mortgages. Working with an FCA regulated broker gives you peace of mind, knowing that if something goes wrong, you have a way to report it or seek compensation. Alternatively, you can also search for a mortgage broker via websites such as Vouch4 or Unbiased, which connects you with highly recommended FCA regulated advisors. These platforms allow you to find a mortgage broker that fits your specific needs, often based on location, experience, and customer reviews. Question two, how much do you charge? It is important to ask your mortgage broker about their fees upfront, as brokers can charge in different ways. Some brokers are fee-free, meaning that they don't charge you directly, but instead, they earn a commission from the lender. This commission is typically around 0.35% to 0.4% of the mortgage loan amount. For example, on a £200,000 mortgage, the broker will receive around £700 to £800 from the lender. This can be appealing as you won't need to budget for their fee out of your pocket. But it's always good to check if this commission is going to affect the deals that they recommend to you. On the other hand, there are some brokers that charge a direct fee. So this could be a flat fee, typically around £500, or a percentage of the mortgage loan, such as 0.5% to 1%. So for a £200 mortgage, you could be paying between £1,000 and £2,000 if charged by percentage. Additionally, some brokers may combine fees, charging an upfront fee alongside earning commission from the lender. It is crucial to understand how and when you will be charged in order to avoid any surprises. Don't forget to ask whether the fee will apply to future remortgages. You know, some brokers offer a lifetime service, meaning that they won't charge you again if you return to them for a remortgage in a few years. It's also worth considering the other costs that come with getting a mortgage, such as arrangement fee, valuation fees, and sometimes legal fees. So be sure to ask your broker if they will help you navigate these additional costs. Having your broker go over your documents before you submit them can also help reduce the risk of delays or complications in your application. Question three, what's the best type of mortgage for me? There are several types of mortgages, each with its own advantages and disadvantages, and understanding which one is right for you, depending on your financial situation, goals, and future plans is very, very important. A good mortgage broker should ideally help you to navigate these options and recommend the best fit for your needs. For instance, a repayment mortgage is the most common option where you pay a fixed amount monthly over an agreed period, usually 25 years. Now, each payment covers both the interest and also the capital, that's the loan amount. And by the end of the term, you'll have fully repaid your mortgage on this property and you can own the property outright. This option gives you peace of mind, knowing that you are gradually paying off the loan and the debt will eventually be cleared. On the other hand, with an interest-only mortgage, you only pay off interest on the loan each month. This means that your monthly payments are lower, but you will still need a plan in place to repay the capital in full at the end of the mortgage term, either by selling the property, using savings, or investing somewhere else. Interest-only mortgages are most common for buy-to-let investors, but they can be riskier for residential buyers if they don't have a clear strategy for repaying the capital. And these are just two of the many mortgage types that are available. There are others which include fixed rate mortgages, where your interest rate is fixed for a set period of time, say 2 years or 5 years, depending on what you want. This actually gives you predictable payments. There's also the variable rate mortgage, where interest rates can change over time depending on the lender's rate or the Bank of England's base rate. There are also tracker mortgages which follow the Bank of England's base rate directly, and offset mortgages where savings are linked to your mortgage to reduce the interest you pay. Your mortgage broker should help you assess all these options based on your income, your long-term goals, like whether you plan to stay in the property for a short or long time, and your risk tolerance. They will also be able to explain how each type works in practice and how it aligns with your personal and financial circumstances. 4. How many lenders can you assess? The number of lenders that a broker can assess directly impacts the variety of mortgage deals that they can offer you. So if you are looking for the most competitive deals, it's important to know whether your broker is a whole of market broker or restricted to a smaller section of lenders. A whole of market broker can assess all the lenders and products across the market, meaning that they can compare deals from high street banks, specialist lenders, and smaller building societies. This gives you the broadest range of options, and it also increases the likelihood of finding a mortgage with better rates or terms that suit your needs. Whole of market brokers have the flexibility to tailor their advice to your specific circumstances. So whether you are looking for a low deposit option or a fixed rate mortgage or a product for self-employed buyers. On the other hand, single tied brokers are limited to one lender. They can only offer you mortgage deals from that specific lender, which could restrict your options and prevent you from assessing more competitive rates elsewhere. This might actually work if you are already set on a particular lender, but it is less ideal if you want a wider choice. The multi-tied brokers fall somewhere in between. They work with a panel of lenders, which gives them access to more options than a single-tied broker, but not the full range available across the market. Now, while this can still provide you with some good deals, it's important to ask how many lenders are on their panel and whether there might be better offers outside of this group. Also, it's important to ask your broker whether they offer exclusive deals that you won't be able to find on your own or through a lender directly. You know, sometimes brokers have access to special mortgage rates or products that are only available through intermediaries. So knowing how many lenders and products your broker can access will help you to decide whether you are getting a competitive view of the market or not. Question 5. How much do I need to save to buy my home? The amount you need to save will largely depend on the price of the property that you are looking to buy, and also on the percentage of that value that your mortgage provider is willing to lend you. This percentage is known as the loan to value ratio, LTV. So the higher the LTV, the smaller your deposit needs to be, but the higher your mortgage repayments and interest rates might be. For example, if you're a first-time buyer, you can typically get a mortgage with up to 95% LTV, meaning that you need to save only 5% deposit. So for a £200,000 property, you need to save £10,000 for the deposit. However, while a 95% LTV allows you to get on the property ladder with a smaller deposit, lenders often charge higher rates on these deals because they are seen as higher risk. So if you are able to save a larger deposit, such as 10% or even 20%, you likely qualify for more competitive mortgage deals with lower interest rates and monthly payments. For example, if you can save a 20% deposit for the same £200,000 property, you need £40,000. This not only reduces your loan size, but also makes you a more attractive borrower to lenders, giving you access to better deals that can save you money over the long term. And in addition to the deposit, you will need to budget for other upfront costs. These include legal fees. You need to have to pay your solicitor or conveyancer to handle the legal side of the purchase. These costs range from £500 to £1,500, depending on the complexity of the transaction and the solicitor that you choose. Stamp duty. First-time buyers may be eligible for reduced or no stamp duty on properties up to a certain value, but it is important to check if this applies to you. For properties over the threshold, this tax could add a significant cost. Moving costs. Whether you hire a professional remover company or rent a van, you need to factor in the cost of moving your belongings. Valuation and survey fees. Lenders will often require a property valuation, which can cost between £150 and £1,500, depending on the type of survey or valuation that you choose. You may want a more detailed survey, like a home buyer report, to check for potential issues with the property. Mortgage arrangement fees. There are some lenders who charge a fee to set up your mortgage, which can range from £0 to £2,000, depending on the product. So sometimes this fee can be added to your mortgage, but you need to be aware that this means paying interest over it over a long period of time. Saving enough for your deposit and additional cost is crucial for avoiding any financial stress during the home buying process. A mortgage advisor can help you understand how much you need to save based on the type of property you want and your financial situation. And this helps you to plan for a smoother purchase. Question 6, how much can I borrow? While saving for a deposit is crucial, it is just as important to know how much a mortgage lender will be willing to lend you. So if the lender doesn't offer enough, even with a good deposit, you won't be able to afford the property that you want. And that is where a mortgage broker comes in. They will assess your financial situation and help you understand your borrowing potential. Your mortgage broker will look at several factors, including your salary and other income. You know, this forms the basis for how much you can borrow. Typically, lenders offer mortgages at around 4 to 4.5 times your annual income. So if you are earning £50,000 per year, for example, you can borrow from between £200,000 and £225,000 to buy your home. And if you are buying with a partner, your combined income will be considered, giving you more borrowing power. Your monthly spending also matters. Lenders will scrutinize your outgoings to ensure that you can comfortably manage your mortgage payments alongside other financial commitments. So this includes expenses like loan repayments, credit cards, childcare costs, and any other regular expenditures you might have. Another thing is your credit history. A good credit score will improve your chances of borrowing more, while a poor credit score might limit your options or result in higher interest rates. Your mortgage broker will review your credit file to flag any issues that could affect your borrowing capacity and help you to resolve them before applying. It's important to understand that borrowing limits will impact the price range of the homes that you can consider. For example, if you have a £20,000 deposit and you are eligible to borrow £200,000, you could potentially buy a property worth £220,000. However, even if you can stretch to the maximum amount, be cautious. Borrowing at your limit might leave you financially stretched, especially if interest rates rise or your circumstances change. Some mortgage brokers also have access to affordability calculators that allows you to get an estimate of how much you could borrow based on your income and financial situation. And it's also a good idea to use these tools to gauge what you can realistically afford before starting your own search. You can also find mortgage calculators online to check this yourself, giving you a clearer picture of what is within your budget. 7. What is the mortgage interest rate and will this change? The mortgage interest rate is one of the most important factors to consider and understand when choosing a mortgage, because it affects how much you're going to be repaying every month. It is essential to know not only what the interest rate is, but also whether it is likely to change over time, as this will impact your financial planning. If you choose a fixed rate mortgage, the interest rate will stay the same for the agreed period, usually 2, 5, or even 10 years. This means that your monthly payments won't change during this term, giving you stability and predictability in your budget. However, once the fixed term ends, you'll be moved onto the lender's standard variable rate, also known as SVR, and this typically is higher than the fixed rate which you have been enjoying previously. So the SVR can fluctuate at the lender's discretion, and it is often a good idea to remortgage at the end of your fixed term in order to avoid paying more. Alternatively, if you opt for a tracker mortgage, your interest rate will follow the Bank of England's base rate. When the base rate goes up, your mortgage payments also will increase, but when it comes down, your payments will decrease. While tracker mortgages can offer lower rates during times of low interest, they also come with more uncertainty, as your payments can change throughout the mortgage term depending on the broader economy. And there are also variable rate mortgages, such as discount mortgages, where your interest rate is set slightly below the lender's SVR for an initial period. Like tracker mortgages, this can change, but they aren't directly tied to the Bank of England's base rate, making them less predictable. So a mortgage broker can help you to navigate these different types of interest rates and advise which one is the best option for your personal circumstances. They will also take into account factors like how long you plan to stay in the property, your risk tolerance, and whether you prefer the stability of a fixed rate or potential savings with a variable rate. So it is crucial to ask your broker not only what the interest rate is, but also when and how it might change, so you are prepared for any future fluctuations in your monthly payments. Question 8. Are there any restrictions on my mortgage? Understanding any potential restrictions on your mortgage is crucial, especially if you are considering moving to another property in the future. There are some mortgages that come with some specific terms that could limit your flexibility, so it's essential to ask about this before committing. One important aspect to consider is whether your mortgage is portable. If your mortgage is portable, you can transfer it to a new property if you decide to move. This can be a significant advantage, as it allows you to retain the same interest rate and terms without having to reapply for a new mortgage, which could be beneficial if interest rates rise in the future. However, not all mortgages have this feature, so be sure to confirm with your broker. Another critical factor to inquire about is any early repayment charges, also known as ERCs. So many lenders impose fees if you pay off your mortgage early, which can be a considerable amount depending on your loan size and the terms of your mortgage. For example, if you pay off your mortgage before the end of your agreed term, you could incur a penalty that may deter you from refinancing or selling your property. Similarly, there are some lenders that allow you to make overpayments, that is paying more than your agreed monthly payment, but may charge you if you exceed a certain percentage of your mortgage balance in a year. So this could limit your ability to pay down your mortgage faster without incurring extra costs. Lastly, it is worth asking about any other restrictions that might apply, such as specific property types that the lender might not finance, such as a leasehold, shared ownership, or new builds, as well as any requirements for maintaining the property. You know, understanding all these restrictions can actually help you avoid surprises later on and give you a clearer picture of your options if your circumstances change. By discussing these restrictions with your mortgage broker, you can ensure that you select a mortgage that aligns with your current situation and future plans, allowing for greater flexibility as your life evolves. Question 9. Can you help me with other aspects of the house buying process? When you are choosing your mortgage broker, it is beneficial to find out if they can assist you with other elements of the home buying process, you know, beyond securing your mortgage. Many brokers can offer additional services such as helping you find suitable insurance products like home insurance or life insurance, or connecting you with solicitors and conveyancers who can handle the legal aspect of property purchase. Having a broker who can assist with this additional aspect can simplify your home buying journey. For instance, they might provide recommendations for reputable insurance providers, helping you understand the different types of coverage that you might need. Similarly, they can connect you with trusted legal professionals who can ensure a smooth transaction, saving you time and effort in searching on your own. However, it's also essential to ask your broker whether they receive a commission for recommending any additional products or services. Understanding how they are compensated for these recommendations will give you insight into their objectivity. So if they do earn a commission, inquire about how much it is and whether it might influence their recommendations. Of course, they will say no, but this transparency can help you feel more confident that their advice is genuinely in your best interest rather than driven by potential financial gain. Moreover, asking your broker about their connections in the industry can be advantageous. A well-connected broker may provide valuable referrals or insider tips that could benefit your overall purchasing experience. So it's worth discussing how they can support you through the entire process, from mortgage advice to settling into your new home, in order to ensure that you have every guidance that you need for every step of the way. Question 10, what documentation do I need and how long is it going to take to get my mortgage approved? When applying for a mortgage, having the right documentation ready is very, very crucial for a smooth application process. Mortgage brokers typically require various documents to assess your financial situation and determine your eligibility for a mortgage. Common documents that you may need to provide include payslips, usually from the last 3 months, to verify your income, bank statements. Recent statements often last 3 to 6 months, showing your income, your expenses, and your savings. Proof of identity. This could be your passport, your driver's license, BRP, share codes, along with a recent utility bill or bank statement with your name and address on it. Tax returns. So if you are self-employed, you may need to provide your last 2 years of tax returns along with any business accounts. Employment details. A letter from your employer confirming your job title, your salary, and length of your employment will also be necessary. And by gathering all these documents ahead of time, you can help expedite the mortgage application process. Incomplete or missing documents can lead to delays, so it's a good idea to ask your broker for a comprehensive list of what you will need based on your specific situation. And the timeline for mortgage approval can vary significantly depending on several factors, including the lender's processing speed, your financial situation, and the complexity of your application. So generally, the mortgage approval process can take anywhere from a few days to several weeks. So factors such as how quickly the lender can verify your information, the responsiveness of your employer or accountant in providing additional documentation, and whether you need a survey or valuation can all influence this timeline. And your mortgage broker should be able to provide you with a clearer idea of how long the approval process might take based on your circumstances and the lender that you choose. They can also guide you on how to navigate any potential delays and keep your application on track. Understanding the expected timeline will help you to plan accordingly and reduce any stress associated with waiting for approval. There are numerous government programs and incentives that are designed to assist first-time home buyers in the UK, and these initiatives allows you to take advantage of every possible resource in order to secure your first home. I'll be sharing more details about them in my next video, which you can find here.